Hello, friends, and welcome to Art with Miss P this week. This week's lesson is going to be a fun drawing of a cup of hot cocoa with marshmallow snowmen floating in it. So here's an example of one that we did. I got my mug of hot cocoa. I've got my marshmallow snowman floating in my cup. And then in the background, I've got striped walls with a window with a curtain. And in the background, outside the window, is some snowmen having a snowball fight. And then here's another example that we did. Again, my mug with a floating snowman marshmallow. In the background, I've got a nice pattern on my walls and a window just showing a snow scene outside. So what you need for this project is white paper, your pencil, an eraser, your Sharpie, and then whatever you want to color with. In the classroom, we used a combination of crayons and color pencils so we could get some nice lights and darks. So grab those things, friends. Meet me over in my studio, and let's get started on our floating marshmallow snowman hot cocoa drawing. Hello, friends, and welcome to Art with Miss P this week. So this week's lesson is drawing a hot mug of cocoa with something interesting in the background with floating snowmen marshmallows in our hot cocoa. So what you're gonna need for this project is your white paper. So get your white paper, a pencil, eraser, a Sharpie, and then I used crayons and color pencils to color mine with, but whatever you have at home, but crayons and color pencils are nice because you can get some lights and some darks. So let's get those things and let's get ready to draw our hot mug of cocoa. So take your white paper, turn it vertical so we've got plenty of room. Now I'm gonna use this cup as an example right here. This is a cup I use for painting, so I've got paint stains in the bottom. So if we look at the cup this way, we see a circle, and we know it's round. I know if I pour water in here, it holds. If we turn our cup to this angle, our circle suddenly goes to a flat circle, more like an oval, and that's called an ellipse. So the first thing we're gonna draw is the top of our mug of cocoa right here. So we're gonna draw an ellipse. So right here in the middle of your paper, where my finger is, take your pencil and draw a oval like that right there, an ellipse. All right, now we're gonna draw the sides. So coming off the two edges right here of our ellipse or our oval, we're gonna draw two lines. Now you've got choices. You can draw your lines straight if you want to, that is fine. Kinda like this picture right here, straight down. Or you can draw it slightly diagonal, not too much because it does not come to a V, or slightly diagonal so it looks like a mug like that. It is totally your choice which way you wanna do it. I am gonna draw slightly diagonal just to give my mug a different shape, but you can certainly do yours straight down. All right, these two lines need to be equal, so I need to shorten this line just a little bit so that it's equal. And the bottom of our cup is not going to be straight. So if we look at the bottom of this cup, you see that it's curved, it's not straight. So we need to curve it, just like this curve right here. So from this point, you're gonna draw a curve like that, almost like a smile. Then we're gonna come over here and we're gonna give it a handle like that. It's kinda like half of a heart, I hear a lot of my students say. Now we wanna draw the inside of this handle right here. So pay attention to this, guys, because we're gonna do something a little tricky here. From the edge of your cup to right there, we're gonna draw a parallel line to this line right here. So these two lines are parallel, and we're gonna stop it right there. Then I want you to come in to right here, so we come in just a little bit to right here, and we're gonna draw a parallel line to this. So starting right here, a parallel line all the way down to the side of our cup, like that. So what that looks like is the inside of the handle, so it makes it look a little bit more realistic and a little bit more three-dimensional. All right, so now you've got a choice. If you want to put a saucer for your cup to sit on, you can. You will just draw another oval or ellipse right here under your saucer. If you don't have room for a saucer or you don't want to draw a saucer, You don't have to. The choice is yours. But if you do want to draw one, you will just draw from the edge of your cup all the way around like this to the other side. Just an ellipse right there. I'm not going to draw one on this since my examples over here have one. All right, so now we need to put in our horizon line. And I'm going to put the horizon line right here. I am not going to draw that line through my cup because we don't see that line because our cup is solid. And if I were to draw that line through my cup, then I would just have to erase. All right, let's get our snowman marshmallow. So we're going to draw snowman marshmallow looking like they're just having fun floating around inside this cup of cocoa. So draw a circle. Well, first of all, before you do that, guys, let's put the back rim of the cup on. That is a little parallel line right there. It's a thin little line right there, but that is the back of the cup. You'll see it right here where it's blue. That's the back of the cup. Let's get that in first. Now come right here. Draw a circle. It will overlap the rim, the back rim of your cup. So you will need to erase that because we can't see the back rim of the cup through our snowman head. Our snowman is solid. So this circle we just drew is going to be the head of our snowman. All right, right here we're going to draw the top part of the circle, second circle of the snowman, and draw a line right there. We're not gonna see the whole body of our snowman because our snowman is gonna look like some of his body or her body is under the water or under the cocoa. So head, shoulders, and top of the middle circle of the snowman, and then we're gonna skip down a space and draw a straight line that matches this one, and then come in with the bottom curve of the snowman. Now, some of you may have it where you can see the entire curve in your cup, and that's fine. If your cup, if your snowman comes to the edge of the cup right here, you've got two choices. You can either have it outside of the cup like this, like he's sitting on the edge and falling back in, or have it where he's inside the cup. I'll let you choose. I'm gonna have him that he's inside the cup. So we're gonna give our snowman some legs. So right here, I'm gonna give this snowman a leg that comes out like this right here and disappears inside the cup. This other leg we don't see because it's inside the cup, but on this example, I drew it outside the cup so it looks like the snowman is falling back into the cup and I see both the legs. Right here, one leg is inside, one leg is outside. You decide where your snowman's leg goes. It all depends on how close to the edge of the cup your snowman is. All right, so now let's give your snowman a hat. So I'm gonna put a hat that's kind of like this on my snowman. Give it a big poofy little ball up there like that. Erase the top of the head where my snowman, the hat covers the top of the head, and I'm gonna give my hat some stripes right there. All right, now for the arms of the snowman, you got a couple of choices. You can have a relaxing snowman with arms behind their head, or you can have arms that are coming out like the snowman is saying, wee, whatever. You decide how you want your arms. I'm gonna make this snowman look like they're relaxing. So I'm gonna put my snowman's arms going behind the head, and I'm going to erase where it overlaps the cup. Let me fix this arm. There we go. Where it overlaps the cup. So I've got my arms. Now for the face. Now you can have a face like this one that looks like it's relaxing. You can have a face like this one. So you decide what kind of face you want to do for your snowman. I'm going to have this snowman relaxing. So I'm going to have eyes that look like they're asleep. There's my nose and a smile. And I'm going to put a button right there and a button right there and a button right there. So there's my snowman, kicked back, relaxing, floating in a cup of hot cocoa. Now I've got room over here. Some of you may have room, some of you might not have room. It depends on how big or small you draw. I've got some extra space right here, so I've got a couple of choices. I could come in and I could add some marshmallows like this right here. And I just added an ellipse with some little lines so they look like small little marshmallows floating in the cup with the snowman. Or I could add a second snowman. So I could come in right here, draw another circle, excuse me, and draw the top half of this circle like that, and that be it. The rest of the snowman's body is like under the hot cocoa. And I'm gonna give this snowman earmuffs. So I'm gonna put earmuffs on this snowman. So, and I'll give this snowman some open eyes. There's the nose and a smile. So there's my two snowmen in my cup. All right, friends. So now here's where you get to have some creative fun and some choices. I have shown you how to draw the cup. I've shown you how to draw the marshmallow snowman. Now it's time for you to decide what kind of design do you want on your cup. On this example right here, I did stripes. This example, I did a snowflake. It is completely and totally up to you to decide what kind of design you want on your cup. Same thing with your background. On this example, I did a striped wall that I colored green and white. Then I did a big window. After I got my window drawn, I decided I wanted to put some curtains on this window. So I put some curtains. And then I did a snow scene outside the window of snowmen having a snowball fight. So there's my stack of snowballs, and this one's throwing a snowball at this one. There's the snowball going through the air. So imagine you were sitting inside at your table, looking out the window at snowmen having a snowball fight. In this example right here, I did a yellow wall, and I did these little arrow looking patterns. And then I drew a window, and I drew a winter scene with snowflakes. So it looks like you're sitting at the table, drinking some hot cocoa, watching it snow. So you decide what you want to put in your background. You can have windows. Maybe you don't want a window. Maybe you want to put a picture or a shelf with some objects on it. I don't know. It is your choice. So you are going to finish this off your way with whatever pattern you want on your mug, whatever pattern you want up here in your background. You can even put a pattern down here on your table. And then you're going to take your Sharpie and you're going to outline everything, including everything in your background. And when you finish with Sharpie, you're going to take your eraser, erase any pencil lines that your Sharpie did not cover, and then using your crayons and or your color pencils, you're going to color. So you want to think about your color. Your snowman will be white, but you might have some blue shadows on your snowman, like I did in these and like I did on these. So, you know, you might have some blue shadows, but think about your colors because you don't want your colors to blend in with each other. You want to have good contrast. So I am going to leave you at this point right here to go ahead and finish all of your details in pencil. And when you finish everything in pencil, you'll go over everything in Sharpie. And when you're done with your Sharpie and erase your pencil lines, then you are going to color everything. So I look forward to seeing your hot cocoa drawings. And until next time, friends, peace, love, and sparkles from Miss P.